So, you want to make some anime lines? Well, take a sip of your guava juice and sit back. Hey guys, welcome back to TutsByKai, and we're Kai. Hey guys, welcome back to TutsByKai, we're Kai, and today we're back in Blender 2.82, I think. I don't know. I don't even know what I'm doing. Alright, I have no idea what Blender is. This is the first time I'm using it. Alright, so we're gonna get started today. We're deleting default cube, delete, and we're also gonna select our lamp, delete that too, and with our camera selected, we're gonna Alt-G to clear the location, and Alt-R to clear the rotation. Somebody asked me why I do that all the time, and I always say that because a lot of people don't know how to clear that, and then if I skip it, they're like, how do you do that? And then I gotta say it in the comments, so that's why I say that. Anyway, Rx to rotate 90 degrees on my numpad, so 90 on my numpad. Left click to confirm, and then we're gonna hit GY to move the camera backwards like that, and then hit 0. Middle mouse button to pan and zoom around my screen. So, now, this is the super easiest thing. It's insane how I came up with this. I would literally wish, like, what would be the easiest way to do this? And this is literally the easiest thing in the world. So, we're gonna hit Shift A to add in a mesh plane. Then hit RX 90 on my numpad and left click to confirm that. Tab to go into edit mode. And then we're going to select these bottom two vertices by holding down shift and then left clicking both of those ones on the bottom there. Then I'm going to hit S0 to scale them completely together. Then left click to confirm that. Then I'm going to select these two top pieces up here by holding down shift and then hitting GZ to move them upwards like that. And then hit SX to scale them inwards, so they're like really thin, like that. So it's like sharp, or like a sharp boy. Yeah, there we go. Tab to go back out of edit mode because we don't need that anymore. Actually, we do need that. So go back in edit mode. Hit double tap A to select everything. Make sure it's all orange, and then hit GZ to move it up. Now you can see this little dot right here. Let me get rid of my 3D cursor. Yeah. All right, cool. So you see this little dot right here, this one, this orange dot is the center pivot point. So whenever we rotate, it's going to rotate around that. So I want to move this point up to about like maybe half of in between the center and then the top of the camera. So maybe about half, about right there, something like that. Then hit tab to go back out of edit mode. All right, cool. Hit S to scale it down a little bit because this is kind of big right now. And now what we have is one single line. Now, I want to go ahead and before we duplicate these, I want to grab the material tab here and open up a new material. Hit this little guy right here, the little box, and then select that material. Sweet. Now, with this surface, I want to change the surface to, of course, an emission shader. That's how you pronounce it. At least that's how they do it in France. And then we're going to just change my start frame to 0 and then go to 0. Now we're ready to get some stuff done. I'm actually going to go to my main tab here and change my color management to standard instead of filmic. Boom. And now we can hit RY and just rotate this thing around. Now, you don't want to see the edges in the camera, so make sure that's always past the camera's view. Now, we can just rotate these. So, I'm going to leave one going straight like that. I'm going to hit Shift-D to duplicate this and then right-click to cancel the movement and then just hit RY and then just rotate these. I'm going to do one every such and such about that. So, what is this, 45, maybe 45-ish degrees, kind of, maybe. So we'll do something like that, just on these corners like that. Yeah, so the four corners and then two, one going up and one going down. Now I'm going to select those by holding down shift and left-clicking all of them. There we go. Then hit shift-D, right-click to cancel that movement, and then R-Y to rotate them in between. Sweet. Now we got something like this, but I want to hit S to scale them up because I don't want them all to be the same size. I'm going to select our camera and then go to the camera tab, go to camera, no, not camera, go to viewport display, then passer part out and turn the opacity all the way up because we don't need that. Now these are kind of in the way as well, so they're kind of getting in the way, so I'm going to scale those up a little bit, and I kind of want to flesh this out some more, so I'm going to hold down shift and select all these again, and then we're going to make more lines. So shift D, right click to cancel the movement, RY, like that, and then hit S to scale those up. Now we are all ready to go. This is anime if I've ever seen it. So we're ready to go now, but now you can see when I play this, they're not moving, they're not doing nothing. Well, how do we fix that, you ask? Hey Kai, how do we fix that? That's what you ask. So we're gonna do that right now. We're gonna go ahead and split my window into two, and we're going to just drag that open. Just from that little top piece, you see your cursor turns into a plus, just drag that open until you get to there. About halfway, I guess, and then select this little box, and then we're going to go to the graph editor, With our camera selected, I want to go ahead and open up this little tab on the right-hand side. And we're going to hit down here in our timeline. You see we're on zero. In our viewport, I'm going to hit I. And then we're going to choose rotation right here. Now, with the object transform, I'm going to grab the Z rotation and add a modifier on the side right here. Add a modifier. This modifier is going to be, of course, noise. Now, when we play this, you can see that the camera is kind of going back and forth. You can see that's what it's doing right now. It's kind of going like just on the Y-axis, which is nice, but that's not enough. So, my friends, we're going to bump this up way too much. So, the strength, we're going to bump up the strength to from 1 to 100, or as Drake says, 0 to 100. So, we're going to go ahead and take a look at that. Now, you can see we've got some pretty good-looking stuff. That's some anime lines right there. It's insane how well this works just with the camera itself moving, and that's it. That's insanity. Now, if I go to the rendered viewport, you can go ahead and go to the color world tab and change that to black. And now you see we got our anime lines. Now, you can scale these to make them even thinner by going ahead and hitting B and box selecting every single one of these. And then going up here to local transform orientations, I believe it is. And then hitting S. Turn that off. No keyframe, then hitting S, and then single tapping X. So S, X, and then you can scale them to make them even thinner if that's what you want. And then play, you can see that we now have even thinner anime lines, which is just, like, insane. It works this well. Like, that's crazy that this looks that good just from the single rotation. Now, you can do this even, you can bump this up even further by selecting the camera and then like changing the scale down some more, so 0.2 maybe, even something like that, or maybe you can even do a higher, what does it look like if we do 1,000? It doesn't even change, it doesn't even look any different, it's just going so fast already. But yeah, so that's pretty much it for our anime lines. Super fast, like really, really, really way too simple. It's like, I feel like I'm cheating. That's what I feel like right now. But yeah, so that's that. Hope you, ladies and gentlemen, enjoyed it when I go out of the camera's view, not even moving. It's just insane. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next one. But until then, bye-bye.